You see, there's no reason. There's absolutely no reason the Marquis Bruce Santee should have to be wrestling for number one contendership. You see, Billy Fives, last time I was in a D1PW ring, you hooked my trunks, you put your feet on the rope, you did everything possible to cheat to beat the Marquis Bruce Santee. Because you knew you couldn't meet the best. So tonight I have to reestablish myself. The man that's been on top of D1 since the beginning has to reestablish himself. What better way to reestablish myself than against that tough enough reject, Kenny King, and the scooter, Vordell Walker. You see, Vordell, you want to come down from Savannah, Georgia. You want to claim your strong style. You think for 1 second I'm afraid of you? You think because you beat up a 50-year-old Rick Steiner, I'm supposed to be scared? Hey, Kenny King, you think because you lost to Mrs. Charlie Haas and Linda Miles, that big jacked up dude on Tough Enough, that I'm supposed to be intimidated? I'm going to make both of you punks pay for me having to climb the ladder again. You see, in this three-way dance, I'm gonna pin both of you, and I'm gonna prove why I am the best in D1. And in Billy Fives, I'm coming after you, son, and I will be the king of Florida once again.
Guiding light, the manager for the Sheik coming out to the ring. The Sheik not with him.
It's interesting. We've never seen him come to the ring before without his main man. What do you think is going on there, Frank?
I don't think the guiding light's going to take on torture by himself.
Well, that would definitely be interesting. I think the crowd here would absolutely enjoy that.
Oh, I'm sure they would like to see the manager get beat up, yeah.
Well, in your case, you would know firsthand. People would love to see you get beat up, too.
People are sadistic, bloodthirsty morons.
As you did right here on D1PW television 2 weeks ago.
Referee Chuck Oren, he wants nothing to do with whatever the guiding light is telling him.
Well, yeah, if he starts pointing to his head, obviously you know there's going to be problems.
He's a very wise man.
He's a very sadistic, sick man. And so is his protege. So as of right now, we have no Sheik. We have a guiding light in the ring, and we have torture on the way, I believe.
That's pretty much a score right now.
Not a pretty score for the guiding light, I think.
And you hear the crowd asking, where's the Sheik?
Well, I believe fully recovered from his injury. It's torture, who we haven't seen in actual sanctioned action at D1PW in some time, Frank.
Well, this was going to be the true test to find out if he really is recovered. Stepping in the ring with Sheik definitely would prove that, but we've got torture in here. We've got no Sheik.
Torture, who is blinded by the Sheik several months ago here at D1PW with a fireball straight to the face and was at ringside. One of the most disgusting things I've seen or smelled in the history of professional wrestling.
Now you got torture in the ring with the guiding light.
What is that?
The mysterious mass terrorist coming in from behind.
Well, that's definitely not the Sheik. I mean, laugh all you want, but what do we know about this guy? Except for the fact that he can jump somebody because of the guiding light.
Very simple. I spoke to the guiding light before we went on the air. He clued me into what's going on. This was the plan all along, baby. You see, 2 months ago, when the Sheik showed up, they had the Extreme Christmas Tree match with Torture. The Torture couldn't compete. He sent someone else in his place to do his bidding. Now the Sheik has turned the tables.
He just folded the terrorist on his head. The terrorist would be lucky not to have a broken neck right now. Drops a big elbow. Yeah! Well, so far, this plan isn't looking very good, Frank.
But you never know where the Sheik might be.
True enough. What is that? Oh, we have an audio problem, Frank?
That's the music of the Sheik. Mind games being played to perfection there by the guiding light and the Sheik.
Disgusting. It's vile. Even what they've done to this man, that is vile.
A turnabout is fair play. It's Extreme Christmas Tree match. You saw what happened when Torture came running out, a match that he was not a part of.
Came running out to save his friend who was having the daylights beat out of him post-match. And being bloodied and decimated.
A Torture chose not to participate in that match. He had no business being out there. And now the Terror is starting to look pretty good against Torture.
Count of 2.5. On Torture. I don't think the terrorist speaks any English. Can you understand the referee?
I don't even know. Obviously, the serious man in the ring brought to us by the guiding light.
Torture catches the terrorist in the corner, sends him straight down. A roll through the cover. Count of 2, and there goes the music again.
And look at Torture looking all around the building. He wants to know where the Sheik is.
Oh, and a low blow. Right in front of referee Chuck Oren. What is that?
But Chuck also distracted by that music, wondering, you know, as you well know, if you're in the ring and the Sheik's on the way, you got to be prepared to get out.
I well know. Trust me.
Crowd picking up the chant of USA, trying to disrupt the terrorist.
Sheik making no friends here at D1PW across the entire roster, that's for sure. For
I don't think the Sheik is here to make friends.
I don't think so either. Would you like to think he'd try to avoid having the whole locker room looking for you on the lines too? You know?
I really don't think that bothers him.
Torture with the symbolic earrings in, I don't think those would help him any. I think those would be a hindrance, Frank. But he does wear those to the ring during his matches. Is that the golden spike?
Actually, it's a fork he's got.
Oh, it's a fork.
It's dinner time.
Not quite yet. Dinner is fighting back, Frank. When's the last time that happened to you?
Well, the cheap restaurant you took me to.
Oh, well, yeah, that's true. But that's all you're worth, so that's the way it goes, Frank. Sorry. Cross the ring goes the terrorist. Big clothesline sends him down. Reverse elbow. Can you explain to our fans why there was not a disqualification when the fork came into play?
Well, it's very simple. When the Sheik or the guiding line is out there, special Arabic rules are in effect.
Really?
Part of the Sheik's contract here in D1PW.
Oh, here we go again. Is he coming out this time? Honestly?
Apparently not. But that's the beauty of it. You never know.
Well, the guiding line's at ringside. Big belly-to-back suplex. Off the middle rope. Here's a cover by the terrorist. Count of 2.
And this terrorist obviously has some wrestling skills.
He's getting a little frustrated. Obviously, he must speak some kind of communicative language.
He's trying to undo that turnbuckle over there.
Oh, that wouldn't feel too good if you get your head rammed into the steel buckle. What is he doing with that buckle cover, Frank?
Just raking across the eyes and face of Torture. Now referee trying to put it back. Terror stops him.
Yeah, stop. Stop before they kill you, Chuck. Trust me. top of the corner. What's he going to do with him? Torture is staggered, Frank.
He sent into the exposed steel of that turnbuckle over there.
He is not in a good way, but he finds a way to place a kick to the gut and right hand. Oh, into the exposed steel of the buckle goes the terrorist, Frank. That's got to be the beginning of the end. Oh, my. Count of two, and he got him. The Sheik's plan thwarted here tonight by Torture.
Obviously, the mind game's working to perfection for a guiding light in the Sheik, but your winner so far today, the Torture, but the war is certainly not over.